6:37, we check back in with Mike Eppel over at 680 News with the latest on business news and a very stern warning coming from a Canadian bank when it comes to a possible trade war.
Yeah, the economists of the big banks are sort of trying to calculate the worst case scenario here, Tammy, good morning, about what happens if the U.S. ratchets up the trade war against, well, Canada, China, Mexico, you name it. They're pushing up these protectionist measures. Scotiabank out with a report saying that, okay, if you include tariffs against the auto industry or across the board tariffs, if the NAFTA talks completely fall apart or what have you, we could be looking at a scenario where we could be looking at a recession risk for the Canadian economy, if you can believe that. That's how important and, you know, trade is to Canada, with our largest trading partner, that being the United States. It's just an assessment or a calculation at this point, nevertheless, brings into some serious questions about what it could mean for Bank of Canada interest rate policy. Net result, we've seen the Canadian dollar drop quite sharply recently, opening this morning below 76 cents U.S. And global markets not exactly overly confident that this is going to be resolved anytime soon, as the Dow Futures Index right now is pointing to a drop of 175 points on the blue chip average right off the bat this morning. So that's quite significant at this point. Coming up this week, we do have some key economic statistics with inflation and retail sales results due from Stats Canada. The inflation numbers expected to show the higher price pressures within the Canadian economy. Retail spending is going to be interesting, considering we've still got these high Canadian debt loads. Have Canadian consumers been slowing their spending habits? Last week, U.S. numbers showed a very strong consumer habits in the States because the economy there is doing so well. And we also have the price for oil starting the week below $76 a barrel, or as we've watched the price for crude drop here, as, again, the idea that OPEC could be raising production quotas for the first time in a year and a half, coming up at a meeting this week. Those are your business headlines. We'll send it over to Stella.